Hello, in this video, let us discuss the solutions for the assignment 4 of data science course. The first two questions are based on regressions. There are different types of regressions. Most of them try to fit the data on a line or curve. So the output can be computed using the line or curve equations. These are providing predictions for continuous data or a sequence of data. But in the case of logistic regression, the inputs are classified into groups. If they are classified as yes or no, or true or false, then it is binary classification. If the data are classified into more than two groups, then it is a multi-class classification. Now let us see the first question. Which of the following are regression problems? Assume that appropriate data is given. The first option is predicting the house price. It is a regression problem. Predicting whether it will rain or not on a given day. This is a classification problem. So it may not be considered as regression problem. Then predicting the maximum temperature on a given day. It is also continuously changing. So this is also a regression problem. Then predicting the sales of the ice creams. This is not coming under classification problem. This is also a regression problem. The correct options are 1, 3, and 4. Let us see the next question. Which of the following are binary classification problems? Predicting whether a patient is diagnosed with cancer or not. This is yes or no problem. So it is a classification problem. And there are only two classes. That is whether he is a cancer patient or not. So it is a binary classification. This is correct. Predicting whether a team will win a tournament or not. This is also a binary classification. Predicting the price of a second-hand car. So this is a continuous prediction. So this is a regression problem. It is not a binary classification problem. Classify web text into the following categories: sports, entertainment, or technology. Here, three classes are given, so it is coming under multi-class classification. So this is not a binary classification. Since there are three classes, it is not a binary classification. So the correct options are 1 and 2. Let us see the third question. If a linear regression model achieves zero training error, can we say that all the data points lie on a hyperplane in the D plus 1 dimensional space? Here D is the number of features. If the dimension of the features is D, then all those features can be fit into a D plus 1 dimensional space if the training error is 0. So this is correct. The next few questions are based on these two data sets, service train and service test. The service train data set contains 6 parameters, and this is the target parameter that will be decided by these 5 parameters. In the same way, based on these parameters, we have to say whether the car is to be serviced or not. Now, let us see the fourth question. Which of the following machine learning techniques would not be appropriate to solve the problem given in the problem statement? Here the problem statement is, we have to find out whether the car is to be serviced or not. Which of the following machine learning techniques would not be appropriate? So this KNN will solve this problem. This is appropriate. They have asked not appropriate. Similarly, random forest is also appropriate method for solving this problem. So this also may not be selected. In the case of logistic regression, binary classification may be done or multi-class classification may be done. So this is also a classification technique suitable for this one. The fourth option is linear regression. Linear regression may not be used here. It is used for continuous prediction. So Only this is not the appropriate method for solving this. So this is the right answer. Now let us see the fifth question. After applying logistic regression to those two data sets, what is the correct observation from the resultant confusion matrix? So for based on those two data sets, we have to create a confusion matrix. From that only we will be able to solve. So for that, we have to run the program. So this is the program. Import all the necessary packages. I am reading the train data set and the test data set separately. The target variable is service. Since service is yes or no, that may not be handled directly. So if it is yes, it is converted to 1. If it is no, it is changed to 0. Now for the train data set, the service column is separated and the remaining columns are taken as input value X and service column is the target value, so it is denoted as Y, and a logistic regression model is created and it is fit with this training set, and this is the predicted value for the given test data set, and based on the actual value and predicted value, confusion matrix is created. So I run all these codes. The confusion matrix has been stored in the array CM. You see the array. The array is like this. You should be careful when you are deciding which case is positive and which one is negative. The sklearn matrix library uses one as the positive default class. So if you know what you are investigating, then label it as 1. Since we have coded service needed as 1, take 1 as the positive case and no as the negative case. So this is positive, this is negative, and this is negative, this is positive. True positive means when positive data is predicted as positive, then it is true positive. So true positive in this case is 29. True negative means if negative data is predicted as negative, then it is true negative. So this is true negative. So true positive is 29, true negative is 94. This is correct. Then this is not correct. Then false positive is 5. False positive means 5 negative data are wrongly classified as positive. So this is false positive. False positive is 5. Then true negative is 94. So this is also correct. So the first one is correct. Third one is correct. So the answer is true positive 29, true negative 94. False positive 5 and true negative 94. Now let us see the next question. The logistic regression model built between the input and output variables is checked for its prediction accuracy of the test data. What is the accuracy range in percentage of predictions made over the test data? For this also, we have to run the program. We have to compute the accuracy. So run this. Accuracy score is stored in this variable accuracy score. The accuracy is 0.91. So 0.91 means it is 91%. So the accuracy range is 90 to 95. So this is the correct answer. Now let us see the seventh question. How are categorical variables pre-processed before model building? Categorical values are strings. They may not be processed directly. To represent the categorical values, dummy variables are created. So the correct answer is dummy variables. Now let us see the next question. Here a data set is given. It is Global Happiness Index data set, GHI report. You have to split the original data in the ratio 3 is to 1. 3 is for training, 1 is for testing, and set the value of random state of the training test split method as 1. So we have to write the codes to solve this question. A multiple linear regression model is built on the global happiness index data set. What is the root mean square error of the baseline model? Here, baseline model we have to create for this data set. I have read the data set and I am splitting it into train and test sets. While splitting, the test set is 1 and training set is 3. That means the test size is 0.25, train size is 0.75, and random state is set to 1. I have splitted the data for training and test. Here, the baseline model indicates that we have to take the mean value for the test data set. So I replace all the values in the test data set by its mean value. I am taking the original value and this mean value as the predicted value, and I am finding the root mean square error. So if I run this code, the baseline model error is 1.063. So the error is 1.06. So this is the correct answer. Let us see the next one. A regression model with the following function y is equal to 60 plus 5.2x was built to understand the impact of humidity x and rainfall y. The humidity this week is 30 more than the previous week. What is the predicted difference in rainfall? Y is equal to 60 plus 5.2x. Now, x has become as x plus 30. That means y is 60 plus 5.2, x plus 30. This is the y predicted. This can be written as 60 plus 5.2x plus 5.2 into 30 is 156. So the difference between y predicted y is, you subtract these two, you will get 156. So 156 mm is the correct answer. Now let us see the 10th question. X and y are two variables that have a strong linear relationship. Which of the following statements are incorrect? They are not asking the correct statements. We have to find out the incorrect statement. So there cannot be negative relationship between the two variables. It is not like that. There may be negative relationship. So this is incorrect. The relationship between the two variables is purely causal. This is not correct. One variable may or may not cause change in the other variable. This is true. The variables can be positively or negatively correlated with each other. This is correct. So the required answers will be these two.